Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this series, you will learn all about React Native from zero to hero. React Native is an amazing technology that allows you to build real native apps, which you can upload to the App Store or Google Play with the help of JavaScript and the React library. You don't need to know Swift or Objective-C for iOS and Java or Kotlin for Android programming. You will learn how to build real native applications with JavaScript, React, and React Native. You will learn how to build your apps with components, how to style your apps, how to provide nice layouts that also work on different device sizes and different platforms. You will learn how to add navigation, tabs, and site drawer in your application. You will learn how to manage states with the help of Redux also, and tap into native device features, how to use the device camera or how to use device location and maps, how to store data in database with SQLite, how to use push notification and how to send data to a web server, how to debugging and testing your codes, and so much more. You will all learn it from scratch here. You will also learn it in a practice-based approach. In this series, we'll start at the very basics, and then I will guide you to become an advanced React Native programmer. We'll build multiple apps in this series, where we can focus on the different aspects, and I give you the source of the project in the GitHub in each session. Therefore, by the end of the series, you will be a React Native developer capable of building your own apps, diving deeper into React Native, and of course, also apply for React Native jobs. So, in order not to miss these tutorials, subscribe right now and click on the bell next to it to be the first to see these videos. Well, what is React Native? Let's start with the React part. React, also known as React.js, is an open-source front-end JavaScript library for building user interfaces or UI components. It is maintained by Facebook and the community of individual developers and companies. We use React in web development for building web apps. React is only concerned with rendering data to the DOM, and so creating React applications usually requires the use of additional libraries for state management and routing. Redux and React Router are respective examples of such libraries. React Native is an open-source mobile application framework created by Facebook. It is used to develop applications for Android and iOS by enabling developers to use React framework aligned with native platform capabilities. React Native knows how to talk to native platform, to Android and iOS, and how to render native widgets. And it gives you a bunch of these widgets as React components so that you can build a user interface with these components. So there are no direct equivalents for that in native code. React Native also gives you access to some native platform APIs. For example, it helps you use the device camera and gives you tools to connect JavaScript code to native platform code. You can also write native code for iOS or Android, and React Native gives you the tools to connect your JavaScript code to that native code. Although this is a bit more advanced, and in many applications, you will never need it. So React Native always gives you a way to connect JavaScript to native code as well as pre-built native features. So if you then combine React Native with React.js, which knows how to update and control a user interface, then you get everything you need to build a real native mobile app that you can upload to the App Store or Google Play, so you get a real native mobile app as a result in the end. So how React Native works? As I mentioned, we build an app and our code typically looks something like this. In React for the web, we use HTML. But in React Native, we use special components in JSX format like view and text here, because the normal HTML elements are not supported. These components are compiled in React Native and converted to native elements in native apps. For example, if you're using React for the web, you work with a div to structure your content. If you would work directly with Android, you would work with an Android view to structure your content. And on iOS, that would be the UI view widget. In React Native, we use view tag, which acts like div tag in HTML and actually compiles into native widgets on Android and iOS. For UI, React Native gives you a special components, which are then compiled to native views. For your other logic, if you're sending HTTP requests or you're transforming data, all your other JavaScript code is not compiled to native code, but instead it's running on a special thread hosted by React Native. Well, in general, it can be said that your code in React Native is divided into two parts: the components that make up the UI and the JavaScript code that make up the logic. When React Native code is compiled into native app, the components that make up the UI become native widgets, but the JavaScript code remains the same. Your JavaScript code runs in a special virtual machine in the end that hosted by React Native inside of your app. This JavaScript virtual machine knows how to talk to the native platform features. So your app is running on the operating system through a special bridge and that virtual machine. That's all automatically provided by React Native. You don't have to care about this part. All you do is you write your React Native app with JavaScript and with these special components. And that's all you need to know for now. This is how React Native app works. So there we go. That is your introduction to the course. So in the next video, let's get set up with React Native and start actually creating our app. Now, if you do enjoy the video, please don't forget to share, subscribe, and like. And I'll see you in the very next tutorial.